everybody give Turtle your attention, please?
Thanks, guys. Henry? Cool. All right. It's been years since his last sighting. Even longer since communication. The albino yeti. And the skinny Sasquatch. Who's Brian? Paris squawked. Also, when I realized Brian rhymes with mine.
That's how the story read. But that's not how it went. This is me. Turtle. Several weeks ago, I began dedicating my life towards solving one great mystery. I wanted to find out exactly what happened to Brian. You see, Brian was this wise man in my seventh period creative writing class. And one day, the end of the first semester, he just upped and left. He got up after the final and he said, "Turtle, I've got your number. Maybe I'll call. Peace, Miss Beautiful." It's been ages since his last spotting. It's been even longer since communication has been made with the Enigma himself. Some say he walked school hallways at night. Others that he left our mortal world for a greater universe. Experts have many contradicting theories about his vanishing. Many physicists believe he simply dematerialized, while astronomers thoroughly believe he merely returned home. This mysterious phenom, this unknown entity, has but one known fact tied to his name. In early 2010, he seemingly ceased to exist. By the 20th century, much was known in the ancient Mayans, as well as their eerie predictions of the future, which seemed to play out with frightening accuracy. It was believed by the citizens and scholars of this ancient civilization that in 2010, a wise and noble being would disappear without a trace. I believe this man to be Brian. Therefore, I believe I must find the hieroglyphs which mention him. Then, and only then, can I answer the question which burns deepest in my heart. Where are you? I'd found it. In my haste, I'd stumbled across Calypso's cave. I couldn't believe I was actually standing here. I knew the hieroglyphs couldn't be far, and so I searched, and as I predicted, they were not far at all. I couldn't believe what I was seeing. They were incomplete, poorly carved, and indeed aged. But luckily, in my 17 years of life, I had taken over 24 years of hieroglyph reading, and I knew I could depict what they said. It would only take time, effort, and focus. lots and lots of focus. But to me, they were more than dots and lines. They were a picture. Moving pictures, in fact. Pictures that told a story. A magnificent story. There was once a wise, blonde, skinny, pale kid in school. But he left school. He went on a journey. I couldn't believe what I was seeing. This journey took him across many lands. One land where he found some sort of plant which he lit on fire. And it brought him into some emotional journey. I couldn't understand what was happening. Then he traveled home. Here he found food. He sat on the couch. He thought. And he ate. And he laughed. And ate. And then I heard this really completely. I couldn't believe it. I would never know what happened next. How could I use this to find Brian?
Alright, we're filming.
Hey,
I'm Turtle.
Hey,
we're in the woods right now.
Me and my camera crew.
We are looking for the plant that Brian used to have this kind of this transformation, this journey, whatever it was. We're looking for evidence. This is just fascinating. I've never been in the Venezuelan jungles before. Okay, it looks like we're gonna get a good shot over here. Some kind of animal. I think.
You better tell me that.
Okay.
Like, I expect to see a chopper tonight.
This is deep in the jungle. Let me tell you.
It's okay. From an Air Force agent.
Oh. Hey, Paul. What you doing?
Stay focused. We're looking for the plant. Now, all I know is that it looks like some kind of, like, mysterious, like, outbranching. Usually there's about five leaves. What was that?
What the hell was that? Look around. Hey, there's something moving down there. Right there.
Where?
Look over there. Paul, get out of there. Hey.
The beast. He took out every one of us. Everyone but me. Seems to have hit me in the throat. I don't know if I'll recover from these injuries. I don't know if I'll be able to survive in the wilderness by myself. It's been a couple of minutes, and I'm feeling pretty hungry. Low on vitamins. Looks like I'm gonna have to drink my own pee. Lots and lots of my own piss. Luckily, I think he's had his full feast. He won't be coming back for more. Now all I have to do is find this plant. The very plant that Brian found. I'm looking for some kind of five-leaf, maybe cloverous flower thing. I don't know. All I know is I have to light it on fire. And I'll go where Brian went. My own piss doesn't taste very good. As you can see, constructed my own hut. Hopefully it'll provide shelter for the next hailstorm. Turns out there's ants here. Really, really hurt. I'm gonna move. No! No. No! It can't be! This is it. The side effects of the plants were astounding. Then it hit me. Brian had many close friends I could ask about him, specifically Paris. I knew she would have some idea of what happened to him. I had a picture, but I couldn't find it.
There you are.
I'd gathered several of his friends and several very knowledgeable sources.
Hey, Alec, thanks for coming out.
Yeah, of course, man.
Great to have you here. Alright, so let's go ahead and jump right into it. How'd you know Brian?
Well, I met him through Duncan when we were little kids, and since like first grade, about.
So, early childhood friends?
Yeah.
No, y'all go way back?
Way back.
Who's Brian?
Brian Carter?
Oh. Huh?
How do you know
him? Well, my lab partner first told me about Brian Carter a few months ago. Mm-hmm. He wanted me to help him run some experiments, finding out why he disappeared. I brought with me the notes from those lab experiments. The research I gathered was all right here. This is a complex algorithm I wrote, explaining that he may have just simply dematerialized. You can keep that if you like.
Oh, I'd love to. Thank you very much. What do you think happened to him?
Well, in fact, I know what happened to him. Mm-hmm. He hangs out at home pretty much every day.
Sure,
you're aware of like what he's doing there, you know, and probably spoken to his girlfriend. She knows where he is, too. Lives over there in the Schoenberg district, you know. Hangs out with Duncan every once in a while. You can pretty much find him there.
Why? Well, we met Margaret.
So, Paris, what do you think happened to Brian? Paris.
Well, it is my firmly held belief that at some point in 1000 BCE, he had gloriously arrived in South America as a being from another world.
Really?
And he taught these savages how to farm, irrigate, hunt, and build pyramids. And they worshipped him and made many hieroglyphs, such as the ones you found.
Where do you think he could be found today?
Well, I told you, the Schoenberg district. Mm-hmm. And he's there all the time.
Yeah.
So, and he works at Party City with his girlfriend, and you've probably already spoken to her.
Alec was leading me nowhere.
Sometimes mornings,
and I was in no mood for jokes.
Where do you think he could be found today?
Centaur.
Paris! Paris! So you have no idea where he is?
No, I know exactly where he is. We're seeing a movie this evening. Uh-huh. Robin Hood?
Yeah, you are no help to me at all. If you're just going to be a piece of you're on leaving.
I have his number if you want to reach him. Hey, Brian. Yeah, dude, what's going on? Yeah, the movie tonight? I'll come and get you in a little bit. By the way, this kid Turtle is looking for you. He says he knows you.
Brian Carter. Any idea? Brian Carter, know where he is?
Yeah, I do. Yeah.
You know where Brian Carter is?
Yeah, I'm right here.
Security! Get this kid out of here. Can't deal with this crap anymore. Long day of interviewing. What was that? 4 or 5 people, a scientist, a couple of his best friends. No one can really help me out. I mean, I'm sure Paris gave me some useful information. The scientist gave me the most probable theory, but honestly, I'm thinking maybe I go back to the Mayan ruins, look there, or something. Or some other ruins somewhere. All I know is I don't know where to look for Brian Carter. Where would
Brian
I look?
Brian Carter?
Yeah.
Hey, I know that guy. He's my nephew.
You know Brian?
Yeah, he works over at Party City.
Right.
Where are we?
I have no idea. Enough games.
You're not Brian?
No, man, I don't even know who that is.
Dude, look, I'm sorry. You just want to go chill?
All right.
Somewhere, I got this plant that's pretty cool. We
could just Where was Brian? Was there a Brian? Was it even important? I no longer think so. What I do believe is important is that wherever he is at this moment, he is undoubtedly chilling out, relaxing, and living it up for show.
I'm telling you.
Dead, abducted, or dematerialized. As long as there are certain plants on this earth, Sidney Sasquatch will be at peace. Live in peace, Albino, but L.A.
Yeah, but you have to act like me.
No.
Fucking stupid ass man. Stupid ass man. Stupid ass man.
Yeah, go. Alright, then, actually. Wait, totally, you're supposed to be punching.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, because I stopped punching you already.
Okay, and let's do another one, Scott. Where do you think he could be found today?
Scott.
Where do you think he could be found today?
Oh, no.
I am tribe leader, and this is why.
Action.
So what do you think happened to Bride?
Duty.
So what do you think happened to Brian?
Why did you do that?
I don't know.
Who are you?
So what do you think happened to Brian?
Hey, ready?
That's hilarious.
I got it.
What do you think happened to
Brian? 1, 2, 3. So what? So what do you think happened to Brian? What do you think happened to Brian?
Alright, let's try and get it right this
time.
Just get that.